I am here to voice the struggles of the grassroots women, especially small-scale farmers, and who are affected by gender-blind and gender-insensitive climate change policies, and also the industrial agricultural system that is taking place in our country. Since 2016, the representatives of the South African government have frequently used the term radical economic transformation. In the name of radical economic transformation, our government is allowing and supporting the merger of super huge corporations like Monsanto and Bayer to take control of the seed market in the country. Monsanto promotes itself as a sustainable agriculture company. They claim that in agriculture, we need to scale up the use of chemicals and technologies such as genetically engineered to feed a growing global population, claiming that 800 million people in the world are chronically hungry. As consumers, I think we have the right to know what is it that we're putting in our bodies and what type of system is our money used to support. Monsanto also claims that the increase in monocropping and genetic engineering is the cure. That is actually not a cure, it is a disease to our society and to our nature. The corporations defend and promote industrial agriculture by claiming that it feeds people. But the main aim of the industrial agriculture is not feeding the world population, it is profits. Damage and restoration to the industrial agriculture, remedies like the agroecology, which strives to design an agricultural system and it works in harmony with nature and the ecological system. In 2011, the United States reports that the benefit of agroecology, if sufficiently supported, can double food production in the entire region within 10 years while mitigating climate change and alleviating poverty. Strategy, which is used to eliminate the need for using toxic chemicals. And also it's healing the soil in eliminating the need for using synthetic fertilizers. And people at local level, they use the traditional and indigenous knowledge of mulching, using intercropping, and also using some traditional mixtures as pest repellent rather than using the chemical pest repellents. Yes, there are better solutions to sustainable solutions to mitigate the effects of climate change. As I have mentioned, the others, there's also the traditional open pollination of seeds, which is used, and it has naturally drought-tolerant seeds. We need to learn how to work with nature and not against nature. And it is important for the voices of civil society and grassroots communities to be heard within the policy lawmaking arena in South Africa. The South African way is to look to the state to deliver on action to prevent corporation expansion and to develop alternatives that are not harmful to the nature and also to the communities. Some of the alternatives which will help small-scale farmers is to decentralize large-scale farmers and empower the small-scale farmers. Agroecology is the way to solve problems of hunger and climate crisis, and also cooling the planet. The goal of agroecology is to feed all nations with healthy food while caring for Mother Earth and attempting to solve the climate crisis. Also, the heritage variety of crops have more resilience to drought and other factors than the monocropping system of the industrial agriculture. I thank you.
Thank you.